Hi friends, welcome back to the channel. Today I'm sharing with you a neat little AI tool that lets you import a video and it will dub it into another language. So you can either link up your YouTube or TikToks, or you can drop a video file into this page here. So let's link up one of my YouTube videos. So a short one on Simpson's paradox. Links up pretty quickly. We choose our source language, our translation language. I have not done this yet, so this is my first time looking at it as well. So let's take a quick look. So our source language here is English. Our translation language, they actually give us a lot of options. So I went and looked at my Google Analytics, figured out some of the more common languages that people have been translating my content into, and there was actually a few of them. I thought I might try Spanish just as a first trial here. But one thing we notice is that there is actually a whole lot of different options. So it's not just Spanish as a generic, we can see lots of different countries here. And that kind of gives me a little bit of pause as to whether I should choose Spanish or not. I think we still will. Maybe we'll choose Mexican Spanish. I've got the choice of AI voices or sound-alike voices. Sound-alike voices does cost more. Currently, I'm just on the free plan, so we will be doing the AI voices. Voice replacement, smart voiceover, or voiceover. So I'm going to go with the smart voiceover. This particular video does have some very gentle background music, so we are testing it a little bit more than if it was just straight audio. So we'll choose that. We'll hit continue. I purposely chose something that was short enough so it would fit into the free 5 minutes. We'll hit translate. Okay, so that took only a couple of minutes. It was relatively quick to translate this 3 minute video. Once it was done, it said completed. We've got a drop down here. We can download an audio file, video file, and subtitles. So if we want to take a look at what the original video looked like, it is here on YouTube. We can give it a quick play.
And it can lead to you making incorrect conclusions in your modeling.
And now the one that we've downloaded here is our translated one. And let's see how it sounds in Spanish.
Hola amigos, hoy quería hablarles de lo que se llama la paradoja de Simpson.
So we can tell that doesn't really sound like me. That is okay. I don't know Spanish, so I don't know quite how good or bad that translation was. Certainly the first couple of words, hola amigos, sounds very much like what I would have said with hi friends. Beyond that, hopefully some Spanish speaker can have a listen and let me know how good or bad the translation is. I think I will probably actually post this up. I'll link it in the show notes as well as the Spanish version. And maybe someone that can speak both languages can do a bit of comparison and see what it's like. Certainly, though, it is not too shabby for something that was very easy to use. I think if you were going to use it for much bigger projects, then obviously you would need to pay. You wouldn't be able to choose the 3 minutes. But pretty cool. So this is something that I may be using. I definitely check my YouTube analytics and periodically I will see videos that are very popular in other countries and people using subtitles or translations. And so it'd be nice to be able to provide them with content where it is spoken in their language as well. So that's it for today. Hopefully this was a useful little tool that I've shown you. I'll be back soon for more videos on R, research, stats, AI, and random stuff.